All right, guys, welcome back to NBA 2K23 MyCareer. We're actually going to be playing an NBA game today. So the last few episodes, we've pretty much just been running around the city talking to various people. We started kind of trying to win over the business, music, and fashion districts. And I'm pretty sure for all of our main quests, which I think we have 4 active main quests right now, but I'm pretty sure the next step in all of them is to play our next NBA game. So that is what we're gonna do. But of course, we've got a couple of things to do before we get started, okay? One of which is heading to Brickley's gym, okay? We need to do this whenever it's available. It's probably ideal. So we're supposed to, if we look at our quests here, where is it at? This one. So we're at 0 out of 7, earn 3 stars on hard drills. So that might be hard. I don't know.
Right on time. You ready to get started?
Okay. So let's, yeah, so as you see, normal, we've got 7 out of 7. Now we gotta switch over to hard. And 3 stars, 7 of these. Oh god. 1 minute 3-point challenge. You know what? I feel good about that. Alright, we're pretty good at shooting threes. Aim for the highest possible score. 3-point shots only. You have to rebound your own shots. That's false. Don't lie. Bonus multiplier. Yeah. All right, let's go. Oh. Our release is a little more strict. I see. Hit me. I don't got all day, damn it. Oh no. Oh no. Oh wait, I made that? How am I only at 1 star? Well, shit. That didn't go as I expected. Fuck!
That was good work, bro.
No, it wasn't. Don't lie. God damn it. This is gonna be tough. Oh, shit. I just want to do it again. I think this is one, it's possible, you know what I mean? Hurry up! Oh my god. You guys are so fucking slow, honestly. Shit, this isn't even a 3! Okay. It doesn't even tell me what 3 stars is. Okay, great. So I don't even know what I'm aiming for. Awesome. Wow. Well, this sucks. And is that it? I always forget, but I think we can only do 2 drills. What the fuck am I doing right now? What the hell? Sorry, I don't know what the fuck that was. Jesus. Yeah, that's it. Well, we made zero progress in that, so that's awesome. Anyway, now I'm not actually sure whether it has been 7 days or not. So I don't know if we need to do our gym drills and whatnot. But I will try. Okay, we do have this lady to talk to again, so.
Hey, MP. Great to see you here at the Gatorade training facility. I've got something for you to work on today. Come take a look.
Earn 3 stars on the leg press. I don't normally do the leg press, but I can try that. Okay, so let's start there. What's the leg press? Isn't it? It's this thing, right? Oh. Well, shit! The fuck? I guess we're good. That's kind of weird that I would get a new quest, but I can't actually do it yet. That's pretty strange. So I guess we're not doing that. So this is, yeah, play your next game. Start your next NBA game and take the half court shot during pregame shoot around. So we need to remember to do that. Play your next game. Pre-game fashion walk. I don't really know how to do that, but we can figure it out. Win the districts, win over fans at Moss Point, Robert, Miles Park, and Dreamer Court. And win games with J. Cole at Dreamer Court, 0 out of 5. So, we're just gonna play our next game, okay? So let's see, Ooh, we earned a badge. I didn't even realize that, but shooting. What's amped? Reduces the penalty that fatigue has on a player and their ability to make shots. Increases the ability to knock down perimeter shots when spotting up patiently. Shot attempts that occur during the final moments of the fourth quarter or in any overtime period receive a large boost. That's pretty good. After a player has taken a small handful of shots, an additional boost to shot attributes is given for every subsequent shot, whether it's a make or a miss. When attempting to get open off screens, the player more effectively navigates through traffic, boosts the effectiveness of pull-ups, spin shots, and fadeaways from the mid-range area. Increases the ability to make jump shots when defenders fail to properly contest. I'm gonna say clutch shooter. Yeah. Confirm changes. There we go. Very nice, very nice. Play next game. Yeah, I was gonna say we're gonna have team practice though. So we'll do that. And then we're gonna head in. Play our next game. I might increase the difficulty again. Back to, I think it's All-Star, but I'm not positive.
Hey, what you working on?
Okay, so we'll do our team stuff first, and then we'll do our individual drills.
Huddle up, gentlemen. Great win last night. Don't expect our road to get any easier, though. We need to stay focused today so that we can go out there and keep this positive streak going. We have got to find a way to create more scoring opportunities in transition. Let's get on the baseline and work on filling the lanes better and getting the ball to the middle of the floor.
Okay, so I was gonna say we're probably gonna do some fast break stuff. 2-on-1 fast break situation. All right, let's do it. This theoretically should be very simple. Very simple. Like, this is all it is. This is pretty easy, I must say. Oh, he's just gonna take that himself. Way to go, dude. Five for five. We're halfway there. Although I think as soon as you hit 3 stars, it's like you're done. So we could end early. Oh. Okay. What's going on? Beautiful. That's it. Yeah, let's go. Get height.
Good job. Move on to the next drill.
Oh, that's not it. Timed partner three-point shooting. You and your partner take alternating three-point shots from anywhere on the court. After you shoot, get your own rebound and pass it to your partner. 2 minutes to make as many as you can. Consecutive makes plus five. All right, guess I'm starting. Ooh, I missed. Fuck. Nice. Oh my god, we're amazing! We didn't even use up half the time.
Make sure you get some reps in before you leave the gym.
Okay. So we're done with that. Now let's work on our individual stuff. We got four drills. Okay. Looks like we are pretty darn close to getting a playmaking and a defensive slash rebounding badge. Let's do playmaking. Alley-oop passing. That sounds like fun. You know what? Yeah, let's do that. This sounds like fun. 10 attempts to convert an alley-oop pass to your teammate in a 2-on-1 fast break situation. I am well aware of the controls for that, yes. Ooh! I love a good alley-oop. Damn. They're just so fun. That's Joel Embiid, right? Pretty sure it is.
Yes.
Wow. Nailed it! Absolute slay. Absolute slayage. Alright, y'all didn't see that. So, okay, I think we got the badge. So let's do defense now. Gauntlet rebounding. Help and recover. See, I don't even really get a description of what this is until I click on it. Charge, gauntlet rebound with marker, pick reaction, lockdown, protect the tin, 2-9. What's help and recover? The defender will start under the basket, stop the baseline drive from the corner. Wait. Close out to the weak side and stop the player from scoring the ball. Get as many stops as you can in 10 positions. I don't want to do that. Oh, what the what the fuck? Okay, let me try gauntlet rebounding. 10 attempts to box out and grab the rebound after the shot goes up. Opposing rebounders will become increasingly more challenging as you go. That's okay. This isn't too bad. Come on! See, shit like that's just stupid. What am I supposed to do? God damn it. Stop it! I cannot do anything else. Okay, fuck you. Fuck you. I literally can't do anything. Like, I'm boxed out and they still got around me. I can't do anything about that. Whatever. Didn't even get the fucking badge. Okay, let me try something else. Let's charge. 10 attempts to get in front of the player, attacking the basket and try to draw a charge. Okay, I'll try it, I guess. That didn't work. Jesus Christ, these drills are fucking stupid. There we go. Okay. What? Come on. Okay, I got the 3 stars. That's pretty generous. Okay, we've got one more. Oh my god, we didn't get it that close. Let's pick reaction. You are the on-ball defender. Get to the flashing circle before the time runs out. Okay. I did it, right? Alright, so far so good. That one was easy. Wow. Yeah, let's slay. Slayage! All right, let's get out of here. Let's equip our 2 new badges and get into our game. I'm excited to play another game, but yeah, I do think, I think whatever we're on right now for the difficulty is a little too easy. I feel like the next level up was a little too hard. So I don't know. We'll see. Okay, playmaking, ankle breaker, that would be amazing. Dimer? Needle threader. Honestly, playmaking is a bit underrated. It's got some pretty good badges, I'm not gonna lie. Okay. Yeah, we have to increase our ball handle. What? Oh, I get it. It has to be 71 or more, and we're at 70. So let's see if we can actually do that right now. Attributes? Yeah. Ball handle. Barely, but we can do it. So we're doing it. 93 VC. Okay. So yeah, now we're good. There we go. And then defense, pogo stick, rebound chaser. Okay, yeah, we can't. Wait, what's this? Core challenge must be completed to be able to equip this badge in a core badge slot. I don't even know what that means. Yeah, all those early one level, that's kind of weird. Increases a player's speed and ability to get loose balls over the opponent. Makes players more difficult to get past when playing off ball, as they can grab and hold their matchup and don't get their ankles broken as often. Increases effectiveness of screens, is tough to back down in the post, and drains energy from opponents on physical contact. Improves a player's ability to box out and fight for good rebounding position. I'm fucking doing that after that damn drill. Shit. Because that was stupid. Anyway. So we did that. I think we're ready now. Got the Knicks. So we're 6-3. Wait. Hold on. We're actually not ready. Settings. Game to, so it's on pro. I just feel like that's way too easy. I think we should do All-Star. I'm gonna try it. We're gonna go back to All-Star. We're gonna try it. And it's gonna be okay. I wanna make sure that's saved. Okay. Yeah, we're good. Play next game. Knicks. We're 6-3. Where are they at? Are they even on? I don't even see them on this Eastern Conference, Western Conference shit. Oh, because it's showing top 10. That's why. And they're 11th. So, they would be right after the Bulls there. Man, they suck. Okay. Let's play. We gotta remember to take a half-court shot and do this fashion walk right here. Pre-game fashion walks. Earn fashion personal brand points by equipping corporate or free spirit clothing items and wearing them to the game. Wear matching sets up to 5 items of clothing to earn bonus points for either corporate or free spirit personal brand. Switch up your outfits frequently to earn new outfit fashion points and build your personal brand even quicker. Oh yeah, I love fashion, so this is going to be fun. I love changing my outfit all the time. Picking out new clothes and shit. Okay, we got you a meeting with Callaway after your next game. It's at City Design Academy. Don't be late. He hates tardiness. Okay, so we did that then, right? MVP of the city. Oh, free spirit. So now, okay, yeah, play your next NBA game. Callaway wants to meet you afterwards. Okay, just take that half court shot. All right. Yeah, is this Jake Duvall over here? Bro, do you ever move or do you literally just stay in this spot 24/7?
Hey, can I get a favor? My insurance won't cover this.
Okay, 50 highlight plays plus limitless threes. I am pretty sure I can do that. Okay, arena. Let's get it, y'all. Okay. I mean, I didn't make it, but I took it. So that counts, right? I'm pretty sure that counts. It's time, baby. It's time.
And so here we go. The 76ers to start it. And at this point of the season, Greg, many coaches still are maneuvering their lineups, trying to find the right formula.
Well, especially the younger team. There's no real established pecking order, and guys can be wildly inconsistent from night to night.
Brunson scanning the floor. Harden against Quickly. Just 5 on the clock. Robinson a screen on Harden. Here's Brunson. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
And the first of many to come. Explosive.
Well, that's not an ideal start.
On both sides.
And that's the story of the league right now. Most any team can beat any other team.
Oops,
on any
I didn't really
given
mean to
night.
Do that.
Harris finds Knight. Now, here's Maxey. Runs in covering. Maxey,
damn.
No good. Brunson against Maxey. Brunson the pass to Quickly. No good with
the board.
And here's Knight. He'll bring it up for the 76ers. With how well MP has been playing lately, it's a little surprising, Greg, that more fans haven't gotten behind him.
Yeah, I mean, he's giving them what they want, unless...
let's go, Joel. That's not a three?
Take a lot of great nights.
I thought that was a three he just hit. That's okay, though.
And the action gives us a chance now to send it over to David Aldrin.
Kevin, Doc Rivers gave me a few minutes to catch up with him. There's no question this team can shoot the ball. That's the philosophy he's instilled here.
Oh, shit.
Long-range shooters they got.
Trying to pickpocket.
Move the ball from one side of the floor to the other. And then take that first open look that's available.
Yes!
Thank you, David. You know, another great spacing without the threes.
Let's go. First three of the game.
Really shows up when he pulls up from deep. That is tough.
This is it to Robinson. He kicks it to Barrett.
Oh.
Teardrop shot. And that's good. Robinson
not very good
assist.
Defense on my part.
This guy's such an instinctive scorer. RJ Barrett just goes to the floater game.
He just kind of blew
and
right by me.
Love seeing that great mobile one drive a second time.
Whoops. Oh, okay, Harden.
The aggression that he had taking it to the rim there sets the tone in a close game like this.
Spoke too soon.
Harden against Randall. Pass to Quickly. Now, Brunson. For three. Barrett.
Get out of here.
Barrett with another miss. And so it's Harris will bring it up for the 76ers.
Oh, shit.
This their first look at this year's New York squad.
And two teams at vastly different ends of the standings last year. But they played each other to a draw.
Well, as somebody who grew up in New York and New Jersey, I was a Knicks fan, right? They have such a great history. Think back to the championship team of the 70s, Walt Clyde Frazier, then the Patrick Ewing era, Bernard King. They have had so many Hall of Famers.
Here's Maxey, feeds it to Harris. Pass to Embiid.
Oh, beautiful work.
Holds it down.
And that interior presence of Embiid, guys that big shouldn't be able to move like that.
And Doris, growing up around New York, what makes this Knicks franchise so special?
Well, I think certainly the energy of the city, the passion for the game of basketball, playing in the Mecca. How fired up opponents are to play in Midtown Manhattan. The Knicks are a team that everyone follows.
Here's Brunson, goes straight to the defender for the dunk, draws
that
the
was
foul.
On me? Thank you. Hey, someone's got my back there in the audience. If anything, I thought that was a foul on Embiid.
Come in with the
not on me, but all right.
Boy, that's a play you just practice time and time again.
I wasn't actually paying that much attention, but
added toughness on the
I'll probably go and edit this and be like, oh yeah, that was definitely on me.
After last year's playoffs. The hope is adding scrappy veterans like PJ Tucker and DeAnthony Melton.
James, you were so open, my guy.
Embiid, no good. New York's gone 0-4.
I want some assists. All I care about are my stats. That's all I give a shit about.
Quickly against Harden. Robinson,
I'm just kidding. That's not entirely true. If that were true, I would have kept the difficulty on pro.
Into a rhythm, but so far this quarter, boy, he is struggling to make anything go down.
All right, let's do like a pick and roll.
Embiid
something.
The pick for night.
We practice an alley-oop. Let's. Oh.
A shot, no good.
And the timing.
We just practiced that, but that's
that
cool.
Attempted alley-oop.
Just a missed connection, and it happens. I'm sure they will go back.
I mean, that was 100% on him. Like, he flat out just didn't hold on to the ball.
Here in the first quarter, Harden kicks to Knight. Embiid with a screen on Barrett to the middle. And
nice.
Embiid. That's good on the assist by Maxey. And it's 6 points for Joel Embiid. Harden against Quickly. And here's Barrett. He played real well against Atlanta in that last game. Handle no good.
Boy, 9 times out of 10, that's going in. I'm sure he surprised himself with the miss.
Harris passes to Maxey. And here's Harden. Harden gets a screen from Knight. Harden kicks to Knight.
Damn it.
They grab their own miss. Robinson with the block.
Well, no easy buckets with Mitchell Robinson in the vicinity. Sends that back with authority.
Whoa.
Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession.
What was that? All right, we're out. We are exactly halfway through the quarter, which would mean we are in eighth of the way through the game. Oh, we're not out.
The 76ers leading.
It looked like they were taking us out.
Harris outside. Knight looking it over.
Hit it. Come on, someone give me a goddamn assist, please. Tonight,
76ers moving the ball around.
Okay, there you go. That was actually super risky. I kind of thought I was going to turn it over. 30% assist percentage. I didn't even know that was a stat. Is that good? We have 1 out of 50 highlight plays. Oh shit, we're supposed to get a double-double. Oh. Teammate grade A-. God, we have a lot of in-game quests that I didn't even, like, know about. Well, actually, I did. I just forgot about them. But the good thing about it is like, to get a double-double, like, I literally could just put it on the easiest difficulty just to get that quest done if I needed to.
An inside presence.
Harris outside. Outside Knight. Harris setting the pick for Knight. Back to Harris.
Fuck me. Okay. At least it wasn't a turnover, but it won't.
Rebounded by New York.
To say it won't count as an assist, but he didn't even make it, so.
And guys, they walked
that definitely would not be an assist.
Kind of swagger, and we really saw it play out on the offensive end.
Oh, and what surprised me was how easy they made it look. It seemed like they got something out of every possession.
The pass to Embiid. Basket is good. The assist from Harris. Harris has got his third assist on the night.
That's their third straight make. Off
Wait, when did I get an assist?
Robinson a screen on Maxey.
Am I stupid? Shot I don't remember 12. Getting one of those.
Robinson kicks to quickly.
I might just be dumb.
Pass to Brunson. Down to 5 on the shot clock, and the shot goes in.
Well, it's a close game so far, which is exciting. I feel like on pro, I mean, I know it's been a while, but I feel like we won games. Like, we were winning, like, every game by a pretty good amount, which is part of the reason why I wanted to bring the difficulty back up, because that just is unrealistic. Even though this is one of the better teams in the league, but... Still,
the
just
ball here for New York. Trailing
didn't
by
feel
two.
Right. What were the 76ers? Were they
like
a 3 seed?
Is a softball, left-handed.
I don't quite remember. I think they were a 3 seed in the playoffs, though. Oh!
I think that can throw
with me, though, they would have been a 1 seed. Just saying.
Here's Knight. That one drops.
Yeah,
the
see?
Bucket.
See what I'm talking about?
Again, 2 for 4.
The chemistry has been terrific. Really impressed.
We just got something done. I don't know what the hell just happened.
They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, they've gone a long time.
Leadership skill, I guess. I don't know.
It's Barrett on the wing. He's guarded by Knight. And there's a call on Tobias Harris.
I'm actually really surprised we even made that shot.
The timeout.
Okay, now we're out. Okay, up by 4, starting the second quarter. Starting Evan Fournier, or whatever.
On the court for the Knicks.
I've heard of him before.
Fournier,
I think he's a pretty
Randall
decent player. So.
Small and power forwards. Jalen Brunson out there with Emmanuel Quickly. And it's Robinson in at the center, locking down the middle. Maxey against Fournier. Outside Knight. On the wing, Harden. Embiid with a screen.
I just cannot get assists, bro.
A baseline J. The Knicks pull it in.
That's what she said.
To the left side wing.
Oh my god, I
Brunson with a clean look. No good.
That was not even my fault, by the way. Like, my guy literally was just stuck on that dude. And I could not do anything about it. Can y'all shoot? I mean, Jesus Christ. You guys are so open.
Yep, that one goes. And that's 12 points for Joel Embiid.
He was wide open. He could have taken that.
Showcasing that overwhelming strength. Embiid is so skilled at finishing over the aggressive defense.
Fournier pass to Robinson. Now Brunson jacks up a three. New York, no good that time either. A minute and a half gone here in the second quarter. Embiid the screen.
All right, let's make this work, Embiid. What the fuck was that?
Brunson with it. He's got seven.
Are you fucking kidding me?
Quickly the pass to Robinson. Pass to Brunson. There's the try. Good, and the assist goes to Robinson. Brunson's got 9 points.
Boy, how about the awareness from the big man? We think of Mr. Robinson as a shot blocker. What a pretty pass.
Embiid.
Oh, maybe Robinson, that's where my assist came from.
Robinson's got 8 rebounds
yeah,
in this game.
Yeah, I remember. Okay. We hit Embiid in the post.
Quickly against Harden. That three off the mark.
Yep, that's mine.
He is single-handedly dropping the temperature in here.
Give me
that
assist. Yes!
He is trying to shoot his way out of it, and it might be better for him to pass the basketball at this point.
Quickly the pass to Randall. Robinson left side. The pass to Brunson. To get open is Robinson. Brunson, no good.
No idea why he's attempting so many outside shots. It's not his day, and he needs to either look to drive or get it to an open teammate.
Outside, Maxey to the inside. Knight kicks to Maxey. 6 on the shot clock. Goes up to the stripe. Jump shot is good.
Very nice. Oh, yeah, we're by 9.
Maxey's got the lead up to 9 now for the 76ers.
And the lack of effort to fight over the screen there makes that an easy shot.
You know, we see this all the time. You're basically, as a defender, hoping the man misses rather than putting in the work to get over screens.
And those are the kind of nice inside looks they've gotten here in the first half.
Looking at Philadelphia, they took the win in their last game against the Washington Wizards. Knight finds Embiid. Now, here's Tucker. He's got 7. Another shot. Out tonight. Tucker a screen.
Hit
Knight
it.
Passes to Harden.
Harden?
Here's
no.
The 3.
Randall you grabs the ass.
Board. And close to making the defense pay for the lax coverage that time.
Passes it to Quickly. It's Fournier on the wing. Robinson sets a screen for Fournier to the left wing.
Shit.
For the 3.
Shit.
Count it. And the
fuck
76ers
me.
Lead has been cut down to just 4 points in the bucket from Brunson.
Well, Evan Fournier is a fundamentally sound player, and if his teammates are open, he will deliver the rock.
And certain teams take on the attitude of their city, and over the years, Philadelphia has been one of them. The Sixers known for having tough teams, much like the town.
And while we've got a moment, let's send it over to our terrific reporter, David Alden. David?
Thanks very much, guys. Growing up, Mitchell Robinson didn't play basketball. But a 7-inch growth spurt in the 8th grade changed things. He fell to the 36th pick overall in 2018, but his physical tools have made him a presence. One key to his success, he says, just run the floor.
Ooh.
If you're the first man down the court, you can get the ball. Kevin, that's it.
It does to me, too. Keep it simple and use that. For PJ Tucker. Here's Brunson. He's got 12. Can't hands it from downtown. Brunson's
and
got 15 points.
Just like
points.
That, it's a one-point game.
The 76ers have taken on the identity of Philadelphia. In your estimation, how?
You know, you go all the way back to the 80s. This has been a team that plays hard, focuses
on defense.
Harden,
I feel like, is sucking ass.
Much like their city, so they tend to play with a chip on their shoulder.
And here's Embiid. He'll bring it up for the Philadelphia 76ers. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Knight passes to Harden. Out to Knight. Can they get it?
There we go.
Good. It's Harden with the
assist. That
was time.
Good freaking plays.
Harden's
right
got
there.
3 assists in the game.
Always ready to strike. Mr. MP needs the ball, and once he gets it, he's getting to his shot quickly.
Brunson, no good. The 76ers leading by 4. Harden the pass tonight. Down low. Here's Embiid.
Damn
that
it.
Shot is off. So New York will take it the other way. From 12 feet out. Randle no good.
I'll tell you, it feels all night like this guy's been forcing shots, rushing shots. He's really struggling on the offensive end.
And it does a world of good for them to have Harris getting busy inside. Gives them that inside-out edge they're looking for.
Here's quickly. They picked up 24 points in their last win against Atlanta.
Bad steal attempt, my ass. That was a great steal attempt.
Right wing. Brunson kicks to Randle. And to get open is Robinson. Count it. And the 76ers lead has been cut down to just 3 in the basket from Randle.
Well, Julius Randle has put in time to grow his ability to make 3-point shots. Nice delivery.
Here's Maxey. Randle grabs the board. Randle's got 5 rebounds tonight. Here's Brunson. And Philadelphia grabs the miss.
And the rebound battle split evenly thus far.
Maxey in the corner. Back to Harden. Fournier against Knight. Harris a screen on Fournier. Knight passes to Harris.
God damn it, Harris. You gotta make that shit.
And the foul called on MP. That's foul number 2.
That was not good.
Well, that's 2 fouls on him early. He'll have to be careful not to pick up another one.
Shake Milton. He's
it's almost halftime.
And then for New York, RJ Barrett's checked in for Evan Fournier.
2
and
fouls right before halftime is normal.
Rose kicks to Barrett. New York needs to get off a shot, and the officials calling for a 3-second.
Now that's what I call good defense.
For Philadelphia.
Okay. Oh shit, we're down by 4.
Brunson has been on display for New York.
God.
He notched 8 points in the quarter and has that terrific
8 points, 2 assists, 3 rebounds.
And
I
we've
mean,
got more in
2K not
Sports
great.
Coming your way after this break.
But not bad. Not bad, guys.
Welcome to
yeah,
the 2K Sport in the West, Luka Doncic. Switching
I
back now to the Philadelphia
care.
76ers.
They've
been fighting it out
to
for the first
game before I lose my
and
crew.
About wraps it up. And as the third quarter is about to begin, we go to Kevin Harlan for the call.
And if you're just joining us, we've played through the first half.
Right,
of the
we should
game.
Be starting the second half
so far.
Since we're starting.
One guy who's
all.
Been getting it done is Jalen Brunson.
And you know he's going to put up points every time out, but boy, he made
okay,
it.
Okay, we've been
so
ahead this whole game, guys. Let's really not blow it. Please.
He certainly has
I'm begging you.
And the endurance to do just that.
Harris and Embiid are manning the post
idiot.
Position. Harden out to us.
What is up with these, like, weird, random camera angles?
And you hear the term, like, point forward. But then, Greg, you had Magic
things.
Johnson.
It's
6'9", but
kinda
still
weird.
A point forward.
Oh, team takeover!
Well,
I feel like this is my chance to get some assists.
It's someone whose versatility extends to their playmaking. Magic is the rare talent who redefines the point guard position.
And stolen by Hicks. Embiid is at the elbow. Robinson with the block.
Wait, this isn't going so well.
And here is Quickly.
All right, I'm just kidding. I should not be doing that. I should actually be
Quickly's got his second bucket tonight.
Just
you simply
doing
must
whatever's
play
best
better
for
defense
me.
Than that. This guy
okay.
is too good from distance.
The 76ers trail by 7.
Get some assists or rebounds or something. That'd be great.
Here is outside. Philadelphia moving the ball around. Embiid inside, guarded by Robinson.
Yep.
And Embiid throws it down.
And guys, we've become accustomed to this. Embiid's a dynamic scorer who's comfortable shouldering the offensive load.
Quickly against Harden. Quickly the pass to Barrett. Shoots from 14. Rebound by Joel Embiid.
The shot's there for him, and he's got to take it. I don't care if he doesn't convert. That's a shot.
Let's
he
go.
Has to continue to take. They're getting on a roll inside. Their last three field goals have come from the paint.
All right, it's almost done.
Maxey against Brunson.
There it is. Oh, shit.
Finish it off. Beauty.
Making the most of the screen. That's how it's done.
And it's in the perfect spot, Greg. Freeze him
up
to get all the way to the bucket.
Where Sorry.
The
God
defense?
Damn it.
No fighting through the pick. No rotation. My goodness.
That's not
Barrett
a bad steal attempt.
Rebound by the 76ers. Embiid's got double-digit rebounds now in the game.
Let's
a
go.
Nice shot by Knight.
They're doing work here in the second half. 3 or 4 to start.
My God, it's such a close game.
Brunson against Harden. Now here's Brunson. Defense is right there. Here's Robinson, and he slams it down.
Come on, guys.
On top of Joel Embiid.
Oh, boy. 7 foot.
Got a
athletic.
Rebound.
That is spectacular by Mitchell Robinson.
Nice angle on that replay with the AT&T 5G slam cam.
There it is.
And foul.
All
on
right,
the
that's okay. Make these, please.
Impressive, isn't it?
Tremendous, Kevin. Carrying the Sixers
right,
with everything
stuff.
They went through, even though he came in second in MVP voting 2 years in a row. No player more important to his team than Joel Embiid.
In for Jalen Brunson. Here's Barrett. And the shot falls short this time.
No other way to put it. Just a poor shooting performance for him. But luckily, his teammates have picked up the slack.
Embiid sets the pick for Harris. Over Randall. That one's in there. The Knicks lead is cut down to just one on the bucket from Tobias Harris.
80% shooting to start the third. 4 for 5.
Knight against Barrett. Pass to Fournier. Barrett with the ball.
Why did my guy not move?
And the call will be against Fournier. And that's his first.
I'm telling you, the defense in this game sometimes is so unresponsive.
76ers have gotten 4 of their first 5 second half shots to fall. 80% since the break. Back to Harden. Pass to Maxey. Knight on the wing. Barrett covering. For the lead, Embiid trying to break
trying to
loose.
Draw a foul or
a
something.
Shot by Knight, no good. And the pass to Quickly. Robinson a screen on Harris. Quickly kicks to Robinson. And contact on the shot, so he'll be. Isn't
yeah, I mean, during his first 4 years in the league, Robinson didn't attempt a single three. Has led the league in shooting percentage, so Mitchell knows his role.
Here's Knight.
Oh, let's go. One,
so he'll shoot two here. It's on Mitchell Robinson.
We can tie it up.
Whenever he forces the defense's hand like that.
And let's get your take, guys, and the hustle stats for the Knicks.
All game long, active hands and really out in the passing lanes. And that aggression
Damn it.
And also, guys, the tenacity they've shown on the defensive end is.
I need to, like, change
else.
My free throw animation or whatever.
Oh, and they get in the way of the alley-oop.
I'm not a fan of it.
Harris gets the assist. And that's 13 points for MP.
Okay, we got the lead.
And credit Harris
for
creating that high percentage look, scanning the floor and finding the best option.
For three, Barrett. And the Knicks miss again.
Boy, what a nightmare quarter for this guy. He's playing right into the hands of the defense at this point.
Maxie passes to Harden.
God, this guy saw my ass. Yeah.
Robinson pulls it
in. Oh, I almost got that.
Robinson's got 13 rebounds in the game. Seated. Randall against Harris. And that one goes long. And it's Harden with the ball for the 76ers. Their biggest lead of the game was 9. Harris looking it over. Offline with his 3.
And I thought that was going to drop. It looked good from here.
Barrett the pass to Randall. Out to Barrett.
Okay.
From outside, off the mark.
1 made 3 form for the game. Does he focus closer in? Let's see.
Harden against Quickly. Harden the pass tonight.
Woo!
And
almost had the and-one.
Sends him to the line.
Okay. Get that energy
it's
up.
It's been a rough stretch for the New York Knicks, a team that has only had a handful of playoff appearances in the last
Wow, that was great timing.
Get back to being competitive, GA, but it has been difficult.
There we go.
They haven't been able to attract top-level talent for quite some time, which is surprising when you consider this big market and the status this franchise has.
Not a bad steal attempt. Fuck you.
And Philadelphia making a change here. Tucker's checked in.
No.
Fournier for 3. And Philadelphia grabs the miss. Knight's got 5 rebounds tonight. To the paint, stolen by Robinson.
What? That was bullshit.
Harden against Rose.
That was straight up bull.
And it's good on the layup.
What the
Rose
fuck?
Rose has got 6.
And this is who Rose is. This guy's a warrior, never backing down from an aggressive defense.
Knight passes to Harden. And the call
yes.
to foul, so he's got the...
Oh my god. 3-point game.
And Embiid, no good on that one.
Really an underrated part of Embiid's game. Excellent as a foul shooter for a 7-footer.
Yes!
So you just can't have
How's that for a steal attempt?
New York here in the fourth.
Bitch.
The forward spot will be Barrett and
New York. Jalen Brunson. That's his 2nd personal foul.
The Philadelphia 76ers have made it very clear that they are all in on a title run.
And their front office has been very focused on trying to get top-tier talent on this roster. After the trust the process era, they're now aggressively pursuing titles here in Philly.
Randall a screen on Maxie. And Brunson, here we go. And they'll get another chance. Quickly finds Barrett. New York moving it around. Just 5 to shoot. Brunson, no good.
Not sure what the D was doing there. Clearly a breakdown. You can ill afford to give a guy like him that good a look.
Harden looking it over.
God, they never take my goddamn screens.
Knight with the screen on Quickly. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
Well...
Too much contact, P! Too much!
Of course, we saw in Houston.
And Greg Harden in recent years dealing with hamstring injury. Has he lost a step to age or injury?
Probably a little of both, but we've seen players with a new diet or training regimen get back to peak production.
Oh, that was so risky.
Hopefully, he can as well.
And Embiid, Embiid's got 19 points.
Spreading the wealth. Embiid just has a knack for doing that on and off the court.
Quickly against Harden. Quickly the pass to Brunson. Randle with a screen for Brunson. Driving in. And the rejection by Embiid.
Length plus agility. Great recipe for blocking shots.
Yep.
Embiid's one of the best to do it.
R3?
And breaking down some numbers here. The hustle stats for the 76ers.
Great
is this
job
my, a leadership? Oh, takeover.
Blocking a bunch of shots and just a tremendous effort defensively.
And you also
I got stuck.
The way they've gotten out and run in transition. A ton of good chances tonight simply from being willing to run the floor.
For those just joining us, fourth quarter here. We're just over 2.5 minutes into it. Harden kicks tonight.
Oh my God.
Good. It's Harden with the assist that time.
Dude, we're slaying right now. We're up by 13. We need to try to get our teammate grade to an A minus. That is a quest of ours. So. Let's try to work on that.
David Aldridge. David, it's all yours. Take it away.
Thanks, guys.
We're close,
to Tom
you know.
Thibodeau
we're very
talking
close.
To his team during the break.
And I would hate to
he
fall just a little bit short.
Shot selection. He told them, stay patient. Run the offense. Make
wow.
Extra pass.
Good defense, guys.
Don't have to make up the deficit all at once. See if they start shooting a little better. Kevin?
Thanks so much, David. Over to the left wing. Back tonight. And they double up MP.
Oh, shit.
Harden
dude, sometimes
hit.
They do that at, like,
makes
the weirdest times.
11.
It's, like, just weird.
A bit under 3.5 minutes have passed here in the fourth. Robinson
what?
Finds Brunson. Quickly against Knight. Quickly the pass to Randle. Here's Brunson, and Embiid with the block, and there's the shot clock violation. Now the 76ers with it. They've gone on a 10-2 run, not allowing much. Knight in the corner. It's
damn
rebounded
it.
By New York.
No.
Barrett kicks to Brunson. No good on that one. Now the 76ers take it the other way.
Boy, it's been a struggle in this quarter, and the team needs more from him. There's no doubt.
The three from Harden.
I'm just trying to get
Barrett.
My teammate read up.
Barrett's got 6 rebounds here tonight.
Well, this has not been his finest hour, but give your teammates some credit for doing the job of stepping in.
New York, no good that time either.
This guy just can't find his rhythm, and you look up at the scoreboard, they absolutely need his productivity.
No one near Maxey as he lets it fly.
Damn
and
it.
And the 76ers get it back. Robinson with the block, and he gets it back. And the basket by Harden.
After being held
I don't know, guys.
First,
I don't know that A-minus is
Brunson.
Gonna happen.
They'll bring it up for the New York Knicks. It's a 13-point game.
I'm
Robinson
trying.
Dishes to Barrett.
I'm trying too hard.
A floater, and Embiid pulls it down.
Wow, what a rough second half for him shooting the basketball.
Just
maybe
play
you
normally,
adopt
you know.
Pass first mentality at this point.
Basket good. And that's 10 points for Tobias Harris.
When you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
To me, this is simply stated been a complete lack of defensive attention and focus all night long.
In France.
Greg, you know this. One of R.J. Barrett's dad's best friends, former MVP Steve Nash.
Yeah, and Nash is R.J.'s godfather, no less. So Barrett's had a chance to kind of soak in the game his entire life. And you can see that in his intelligent play on the floor.
Knicks trail by 14. Now, Brunson. Barrett with the ball. Three-pointer. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. And Embiid's got rebound number 17, if you can believe that.
He's having a tough quarter scoring the basketball. Unable to help
Let's go, Maxie.
Close his gap.
Damn it.
With the rebound. And it's out of bounds. They say it was last touchdown.
How is our teammate Greed going down so much? What the fuck?
And Philadelphia has possession. They've played a great fourth quarter defensively, allowing only 3 points.
Mitchell Robinson, when he contests shots, he is flat intimidating. He changes what you're thinking as an offensive player. Wow, Julius Randle with a little flavor on the finish.
Harris outside. Passes it tonight. Harden outside. With a screen on quickly. Harden out to the wing. The 76ers with another miss.
Frozen. Guy is just ice cold, unable to contribute offensively.
And rattles out the dunk. Well, the layup might have been a better shot for him. Knight passes to Embiid. And they call the foul, so a chance at the line for
on this run. Just too many good looks from in close.
And Embiid, no good on that one.
And they're drawing more whistles and working their way to the line here in the second half. Nothing seems to be going his way this quarter.
Well, not at the offensive end, certainly. He cannot buy a bucket right now.
Knight passes to Harris. The shot will not fall. Some solid defense from Robinson. Brunson kicks to quickly.
Who's watching him?
Robinson against Harris. To the wing on the left. Shot clock at 6. Randle with a screen for Brunson. Shoots over Embiid. Shot is good, and the 76ers lead is cut down to just 12 points with the basket from Brunson. Pass to Harris. Now, here is Knight. Out left to the wing.
I got my stamina so bad right now.
Knight. Score the basket is 8 for 13 from the floor.
Talent on
8 for 13, that's pretty good.
For MP. This guy's putting on a clinic.
Quickly against Harden. Now, here's Barrett. Dishes it to Robinson. Embiid with the steal. Brunson against Maxey. And the basket is good. And the 76ers
I think we've
16.
Got this one in the bag, guys.
Off that slow start, giving them a boost here in the second.
Quickly the pass to Brunson. Handle a screen on Knight. Barrett kicks to Robinson. Back to Barrett. And Barrett slams it in.
That's okay. Coming with force. R.J. Barrett, nothing you can do to stop that.
The 76ers leading by 14. Inside, Embiid.
That's how you share the rock. He does this time and time again.
He'll bring it up for the New York Knicks.
I'm sorry if the audio keeps spinning out. I don't know what's going on.
I'm away from the basket.
Derrick Rose has checked in for the Knicks. And so it's New York with it. The dish to Barrett. Overnight, And the Knicks miss again.
Boy, a clean, close look. What a missed opportunity.
That was stupid.
Second shot opportunity. Shooting foul as the whistle.
I definitely think it's too late. I feel like my teammate is barely going up. Like when I do something good, it like barely goes up. And when I do something bad, it goes down so far. Grand total. What the hell is that about? That seems a little unfair.
Why the problem?
Yeah, I think, Kevin, you always evaluate an organization in its totality. You start with the ownership group, then you go to the general manager, down to the coaches, and how is your roster? What caliber of player is there? Clearly, they have not had stability amongst the GMs, the coaches, or the personnel. It does, however, appear that they are moving in a direction with a clear plan now.
1:43 left to play here in the fourth. Knight sets the pick for Maxey. Just four to shoot. Harden, that's good.
Everybody knows that corner three is one of the easier three-point shots. It's just slightly closer in. James Harden doesn't need a whole lot more than that.
Yeah, but you don't have a backboard.
He feeds it to Randall.
So it's really not that much easier.
To end the run. Two free throws coming up.
That was really unnecessary, Embiid. Just putting that out there.
Incredible big.
Okay, that should be it. Wow, 18-point win.
So it's the 76ers winning this one easily. This game may not have been the most exciting we've ever seen,
but
we appreciate just what a clinical performance they put on.
I know their fans appreciate.
Let's go.
Here
24 points, 8 rebounds, 6 assists, 1 steal, 60% 3-point percentage, B+ teammate grade. That is pretty freaking decent. That, it was a good overall game. I definitely had more turnovers than I wanted. I think we had like 4-ish, which is not ideal, but you know. It is what it is. It is what it is. Okay. So do we have a press conference or anything? Meet up with Jake from State Farm? We've got... Is this our girlfriend? Can't really tell. Hello? I'm trying to talk to you.
That's incredible, Carl. Wow. Thank you for sharing. Okay, great. We'll talk soon. Bye.
Is that some good news?
Yeah, that was Carl. And he says they sold more hot dogs in one day than he usually does in an entire month. So something about breaking a family record or something.
Yeah.
I don't know. He was talking really fast.
Yeah. Him and his dad have like this weird kind of rivalry thing going. It's a long story.
Okay. Well... listen to this. They sold enough to put them over the top. The brick and mortar is a go.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Let's go. I mean, I must say, it is pretty random, like, having this much power.
Celebrity in America, right?
Yeah.
Hey, at least you're using it for something good, babe.
Man, may not?
Yeah. But we gotta keep it moving. We're just getting started with Impress Uncle Bobby Initiative, okay?
Now, hold on. This here...
What?
Aggressive.
Yeah?
Businesswoman.
Yeah?
The thing that you got on. Pretty cool.
Good, because it's their stay.
All right.
So, up next, babe, is Tina and Lance.
Tina and Lance sounds like a boy band.
Very, very far from a boy band. Tina and Lance are skaters.
Okay, what do skaters have to do with Uncle Bobby, then?
First of all, Uncle Bobby was a skater when he was a kid.
Still playing.
Yeah, I'm serious.
Uncle Bobby.
Yeah.
Okay.
Second of all, skate culture is huge in this city. Skaters drive, like, 50% of the trends around here.
Now that I can see.
Yeah, and third of all, Tina and Lance are just at the top of their game. They make their own gear, they do huge numbers in their videos, and most importantly, they're all about authenticity. So if you get their seal of approval, it's gonna go far. And I'm not just talking about with Uncle Bobby.
Well, listen, I can always pull out my kickflip.
Oh, I know.
I can do it.
I know, babe, that's what I'm saying. I think you should just skate on over there and get into one of their videos. I have it on good authority that Uncle Bobby subscribes to the channel.
Bet. Let's do it.
Let's do it.
They're cute. All right. Jake. It's Jake from State Farm.
Hey.
My man, Jake, what you doing here,
hey,
man?
Hey, man, you know I came to see you.
Come on, man. Hey, you probably get all the backstage access. Hey,
I mean, they treat me like
a good neighbor.
Yeah, that's right.
You see what I did there?
I see you. Right.
What you want to talk to me about, bro?
Oh, your clothes.
What about my clothes? I'm trying to say, man.
Nothing's wrong with your clothes. I just want to know if you want to wear the State Farm outfit to a game one time.
Yeah, I don't know, bro. What? That's your drip, man. I don't want to step on no toes.
Oh, man, you're not stepping on any toes. Plus, we did something similar with the last MP. Caused quite a stir.
Yo, I actually remember that. Right, I remember that. Right. Yeah,
and
okay.
Plus, it would be my honor and you get a reward afterwards, too.
Okay. So, rock the State Farm drip and get rewarded for doing it.
You already know.
Yeah. I like the way you think, man.
So, you'll do it?
And I look good in red, too, so I'm down.
Hey, that's what I'm talking about. Hey, I'll send over your sizes, okay?
My man.
All right, man.
Looking forward to it.
Yep, be easy.
Okay. Hey, that's pretty easy. I can do that. Meet up with Jake from State Farm, complete a fashion walk in the backstage of the arena while wearing the State Farm outfit. Like right now? Or, hold on. Whoa, I just feel like we got handed so much shit. Okay, we've got this. Go meet Tina and Lance in the business district. Oh shit, what? You've got a date with Mila at City View Restaurant? Oh, is that to talk to the guy? I don't know, whatever. Meet Boss at Dreamville. Meet Callaway at City Design Agency. Oh, that's what it was. So, this is something different? Okay. Guess so. Okay, and those are the same. Side.
Yeah.
I kind of want to do this. Complete a fashion walk in the backstage of the arena. Oh. We can maybe do that now. I'm not sure if we have those clothes, but this, hold on. I think this is right. What in the hell? Oh, here we go. There it is. With the jeans. Wait, that's so funny. Why is there a vest? What? Okay, bottoms. Oh, State Farm joggers. I guess we'll do that then, since it says State Farm. I don't know exactly all that need. Like, I don't know if I need to change my shoes or not. Seems like we're okay. Doesn't really go with the outfit at all, but whatever. Backpack? Oh. I think that's good. Except we're not wearing it, though. Hmm.
You know
what? Oh shit.
Yo, Shep, did you listen to this new MP joint yet?
Why would I do that?
I don't know, because it's hilarious. The dude thinks that he can actually rap, man.
Yeah, but come on. Demo kind of fire, though. Right?
Whose side you on, Pook?
No. MP trash. We agree. MP trash.
We agree.
But y'all mess with Demo?
Not anymore, I don't.
I mean, come on, man. You gotta learn how to separate the art from the artist.
I mean, yeah, come on, man. You gotta learn how to separate the art from the artist. Shut your egghead up.
I mean, this is a well-known concept. I don't know why it's gotta be all that.
That sounded like, and that was good. You're good at the voices.
Yeah.
God, I hate Shep so much. He's so immature. It's disgusting. Okay, I don't understand what's going on here. You know what? We'll just do that another time, I think. I don't know if we can do it right now because I tried to change into the outfit and we're still wearing our jersey because we just finished our game. So, see, now we're wearing it. What happens if I go back in now? We may have just had to leave for... See, now we've got it on. Okay, we did it. We did it. That's pretty simple. Pretty simple indeed. All right, well, yeah, we've got a bunch of, like, they're not necessarily new quests, they're the same quests, but just, like, new objectives within the quest. So we're probably gonna have, like, a bunch of cutscenes and stuff like that coming up, which we're gonna do that in the next episode. We're gonna end this one here, so thank you all so much for watching. We're also probably gonna get out of this outfit. But yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it, and I will see you guys in the next one.